Sometimes there seems to be some misunderstanding about what herbicides we can and can't use in a native grass pasture. As long as the grass is fully established, so in other words, not during the seedling year, but the second year and thereafter, almost any herbicide that we traditionally use on pastures can be used on native grasses. As we just mentioned, there's a number of herbicides that we commonly use in pasture management that can also be used on established native grass stands. In addition, we've got a couple other herbicides that we don't use on our cool season grasses that give us some extra tools we can use on our native grass stands. We want to just go over a few of those briefly and give you some idea how they work and what they can accomplish for you. The first of these chemicals that we can use that's available for use with native grasses but not our cool season grasses is something called imazapic that we buy as either panoramic or plateau. It's the same active ingredient in both products, the same concentration in both products, and so it's the same application rate in both products. Now traditionally, most people think of using plateau or panoramic at the establishment stage as a pre-emergence chemical to hold back weeds during that first growing season. But we can also use it on established stands and at much higher rates because we don't have to worry about injury to seedlings. And at those higher rates, imazapic can be very effective at control of a lot of broadleaf weeds as well as a number of key grasses that can cause problems for us. One exception to use of imazapic with native grasses is with switchgrass. Switchgrass is not tolerant of imazapic and you should not use it on switchgrass. Eastern gamma grass, on the other hand, can tolerate imazapic, but we shouldn't go over an 8-ounce rate. With our other grasses, we could go up to a 12-ounce rate if we needed to with the blue stems and Indian grass. Another herbicide option that's available to us for native grasses but not tall fescue is a mixture of two herbicides, metsulfuron methyl and chlorsulfuron, that's sold as Cimarron Plus. Cimarron Plus can be very effective on a wide variety of broadleaf weeds and is a great tool to use on any of our native grasses. So we've talked about a couple of options that are available for native grasses but we shouldn't use on tall fescue. Let's talk about some of the ones that we can use on any grass, including tall fescue. So 2,4-D, either ester or amine, both can be used on native grasses without any problem at all for all of our native grass species and obviously are very effective for broadleaf weed control. There's also a number of products on the market that include a mixture of 2,4-D and dicamba that can also be used on all of our native grasses. That mixture tends to provide a little bit better weed control and a little broader spectrum weed control than simply 2,4-D alone. But again, either one is an option, the 2,4-D by itself or the mixture with dicamba. Products containing an herbicide called triclopyr are your best bet for controlling woody encroachment in native grass pastures, particularly brambles, locusts, things like that. Triclopyr is also very effective for control of Sericea lespidiza, dog fennel, but not wide activity on a large number of other broadleaf species. There is a product on the market called Crossbow, which is simply a blend of triclopyr and 2,4-D that gives you much better control of a broader range of broadleaf species, but also still gives you that control of the woody species as well, such as the brambles. Another product that's more recently out on the market is aminopyrrolid, which is sold as Grazon Next HL. Grazon Next HL is very effective for broadleaf weed control, is safe to use on all of our native grasses. It is particularly effective on a number of otherwise hard to control summer perennials, including horse nettle and ironweed. So that's a good option there for this product. For all of these herbicides, it's critical that you read and follow all of the label instructions before you use these products to ensure you use them properly and practice good stewardship.